Now, in the afternoon, police issued a statement saying it will be providing a transport means to some of the stranded students to be able to make it home in time for the deadline that is due to fall on the 10th of June. The police says students will be only required to show a valid identity card from their various schools to be able to access some of the buses. It's not yet clear what means of transport is being prepared by the police, but the spokesperson for Kampala Metropolitan Police, Luke Owesigiri, says transport is being prepared for some of the stranded students. That's a very good gesture, no doubt. Let's now go to Jinja, where reports say COVID deaths have hit 47 patients who have succumbed to the pandemic, to the disease rather, with two deaths occurring today morning. The overwhelming numbers of COVID patients is stretching the hospital administration as they are running out of space, oxygen, as well as manpower to handle the cases. Let's take a look.
Out of the 360 something admissions, we have lost dead.
The patients who died from here.
Cumulative death, the patients who have died of COVID, 47.
Jinja Regional Referral Hospital is the only facility that handles COVID cases in Busoga sub-region. According to Dr. Florence Tumugumikiriza, the hospital director, cumulative cases handled at the hospital are 362. However, the biggest number has been admitted in the second wave. She said the first patients in the second wave were received in mid-April, and all the five were Indian nationals who had just jetted into the country.
Our first six patients were actually Indians. Indians, all of them were Indians. And when we tried to do whatever it takes, ministry informed us that they had the Indian type of COVID, which was different from the one we had the previous time.
By press time, Jinja Hospital had 28 patients in oxygen and three of them admitted at the intensive care unit. The facility has a capacity of 32 beds at the COVID treatment center and three beds in the intensive care unit. However, due to the overwhelming numbers, the general ICU has diverted and utilized to handle COVID cases.
ICU, as I told you, as of now, we have a capacity of the three beds, but by the end of the week, we'll be able to take on more when we open the door.
Seven
more, that would be 10. Here, our official capacity is 32, but the highest we have ever gone was 42.
Jinja Hospital has an oxygen plant which not only supplies oxygen to the facility but also to all the other health units in Busoga sub-region. Dr. Florence says that the plant has a production capacity of 24 cylinders per day, but those in need of oxygen range between 50 to 60 patients.
The Children's Hospital in Narfanya, they use 5 cylinders a day. And the accident and emergency, they use 5. So those are already 10. Those are the main consumers. Theater, we use 4. So if I'm to quantify, I think we need like 60.
On a daily basis.
According to the hospital records, daily COVID admissions range between 3 and 5 patients, including referrals from Kampala. The doctor says that this number is higher than the discharges that range between 1 to 3 patients, hence leading to inadequacy of utilities like beds, oxygen, among others.
We have referred out 5 to other facilities, but now we are also now receiving other patients who are coming in. Only yesterday alone, we admitted 5 in a single day. That number is quite high on a single day to admit 5. And we are not admitting those ones who come with cough and what. We admit those who are sick, who are really sick.
Currently, there are 6 nurses and 1 doctor deployed in the COVID ward. However, due to a big number, the hospital director says there is discrepancy in human resource of 20 nurses and at least 2 doctors. Although the elderly were the most vulnerable to COVID-19 in the first wave, the second wave seems indiscriminative, as many patients admitted at the referral hospital in Jinja are the young and those ranging from just 4 years.
We have some interesting patients whom we have. We have 1 pregnant woman. We have 1 pregnant woman. She's 19 year old. We have the 14 year old was discharged.
The 4 and a half.
4 and a half year old.
She's still admitted.
We have, you know, among all this, this is the first time we are getting babies. 4 and a half year old. But now we are seeing a difference as compared to the first wave. The first wave, it was mainly for the elderly, but now we are seeing all age groups.
The administration says that a total of 47 patients have died since the facility embarked on treating COVID-19. Amidst all the challenges, 293 out of the 362 admitted cases have walked out of Jinja Hospital as COVID-free patients. Relatedly, Brian Chisembo, the district health officer, Kabarole District, says the district has so far confirmed a total of 32 COVID-19 patients in the new wave. Cumulatively, Chisembo says that the district now has 123 patients. Of the 32 patients, 20 are being managed under home-based management, while the rest are admitted at the Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital.
Currently, we are having some cases of COVID-19 and in our treatment center. In the Buhinga Regional Referral, we have 12 cases, whereby two of them are on oxygen. But we've had so many cases, right, cumulatively to around 123. That is right from the peak that we are managed at Regional Referral Hospital.
To be able to respond to the new COVID-19 wave, Chisembo said the Minister of Health had provided the district with 8-bed capacity tent that has been erected at the regional hospital. However, he says the tent is not being utilized due to the cold weather conditions in the area.
When you look at our temperatures in this region, they tend to go very low into cold extremities, cold extremes, whereby we find that the very early in the morning, it's too cold, and when we look at managing a COVID-19 patient, it may not be very favorable managing them in a tent. So we have asked the Minister of Health that if they would provide warmers within these tents to ensure that, because a COVID-19 patient needs warmth.
He has, however, decried what he termed as weak referral system, saying at the regional referral hospital there is just 2 ambulances that traverse the entire region. Dr. Alex, the director of Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital, said that they have intensified screening of regular patients on the ward and that they are also working hard to ensure there is continuity of care for other patients.
If people can get some of the services in the nearest facilities, where possible, they should also be able to access the services. This will be able to decongest the hospital by and large. I know the primary healthcare services are available in Health Center 2s, in Health Center 3s, and Health Center 4s.
Story by Ivan Lubega and Roger Sunday for the news.